Hare Krishna, namaste. God bless you. May the force be with you. You know, that really means the same thing. When I say God bless you and may the force be with you, I'm not saying God bless you like bless in its etymology, which is to spray with the blood of the slaughtered, sacrificed offering animal. I'm not down with that kind of ritualism, but I mean, what I mean is may the light shine on you. May the force be with you. God is the force. The force, which was part of me when I was pitching when I was a kid, when I was playing baseball in Swampscott, which is the town I'm in right now. You're on Paradise Road. This pen that I was showing you yesterday, look where that's from. That's from the Lamplighter Inn in Santa Fe, New Mexico at 2405 Cerrillos Road. So what I want to talk about a little bit before I read from, continue reading, 29th reading from Foreseen Beyond Time. We're in chapter 13, the 13th consciousness. What I want to touch on right now, I'll start off what I'm going to say with a quote from Albert Einstein. You cannot solve the problems of the world with the thinking that created them. What else did he say? But was he the one who came up with that definition of insanity? It's doing the same thing and expecting different over and over and expecting different results. This is what we're dealing with in this society in the early 21st century. We're dealing with people doing the same things over and over and thinking that they're going to get different results, such as political thinking and the thinking aspect of you will not solve the problems of the world. You can't solve the problems of the world with the thinking that created them. There's a specific type of thinking that got us to this point of absolute breakdown and impasse with ourselves, with nature, with each other, with what they call the environment, nature, that's Mother Earth. I'm not with the environmentalist movement, which is denying them. They're going after all the climate change deniers. Like I said, it's not really climate change, it's climate collapse. Due to humanity failing to perform its function and its role as steward, caretaker. For betraying, humanity has betrayed the trust of the Creator, which put nature in our hands. We've betrayed that trust, and now we're reaping the benefits of that. The horrors, the nightmares, the consequences, the toxicity, the breakdown, the implosion of the biosphere. What the environmentalists are in denial of, as they're going after all the ones who are saying there is no climate change, all the Trump thumpers. Oh, there's no climate change, everything's hunky-dory, and then you have the environmentalists who are saying that the mentalists, environmentalists, look at that word, how ment is tacked on to so many of these words, government, element, firmament, on and on. Mental, it's the mind, because it all starts with the mind. What they're in denial of is the climate intervention going on, known as geoengineering and solar radiation management, weather modification, hurricane suppression, hurricane seeding, cloud seeding, all this exotic intervention that's been going on for 70 years, as Dane Wigginton says over and over again, and as his research clearly illustrates. Go to geoengineeringwatch.org. If you're an environmentalist who doesn't know that there's climate intervention going on, go to geoengineeringwatch.org and see what the number one threat, the number one contributing factor to the climate collapse is. It's man's intervention. It started with paving over paradise and, you know, deforestation and industry in general. And it led to the insanity, the ultimate insanity of climate intervention, of playing God by interfering and derailing the climate, the weather system with microwave transmissions and aerosol spraying, metal particulates, which is clearly what's the number one factor behind the exponential rise in autism, Alzheimer's, and dementia. Peer-reviewed study has shown and linked aluminum, free-floating airborne aluminum, breathed, inhaled aluminum, which is what we all measure high for in our hair and in our skin and in our tissue. Aluminum is incontrovertibly linked to Alzheimer's, autism, and dementia. In addition to the mercury they're putting in the vaccines, the toxins there. Just look in the mirror and ask yourself, do you trust your government? Not just this regime that's been there just since 2016, but the government in general. So many of these, you know, well-meaning people, you say to them, you know, that do I have a rubber band here where I can illustrate this? Yes, you'll use this analogy, right? That's used about the climate system. It's like a rubber band that's being stretched and stretched and stretched and stretched and stretched until it can't be stretched anymore, and then inevitably it snaps back. And that's the complete collapse and the complete destruction of our habitat. And we're almost there. We're almost at that point where it's just completely as far as it can be stretched, then boom. Some say that that the ocean currents have to reset. I've heard this one. And that we're going to have a day after tomorrow type scenario where it's going to be real, real quick. Real quick. And it probably will be during the winter, like in the day after tomorrow. I don't feel too safe being here on the coast of the Atlantic at this point. I don't think anyone should. All I think of all that. I think there's some cosmic justice coming for all of this, the people of this land who you know, were the descendants of the invaders who conquered this land and jacked it from the people who are already here, so-called Indians. So many of these environmentalists, you say to them, you know, that you use that analogy, right? And you show that you know that there's climate change. There's like more than that, but you know, whatever. For now. Jesus. And immediately they'll go, like the lady I was talking to says, oh, and isn't it just so terrible that what they said about Al Gore, you know, oh, he does such good work, you know. Sorry, but Al Gore owns a whole lot of stock in ExxonMobil. Is he even in the board of directors? I've heard it said, I think. I don't know. Al Gore is deep in the belly of the beast of the Elites. He's one of the bricks at the top of the pyramid, serving his masters, you know, following, toeing the line. He has his private jets, total gas guzzler, total hypocrisy, right? Do what I say, not as I do. People, the cognitive dissonance in the general population going on and the Stockholm syndrome is outrageous. Stockholm syndrome is identifying with your oppressor, as I've shown over and over. We have a common oppressor called money, called finance, called the banking establishment, called the political establishment, the business establishment, commerce. It's not, stop saying capitalism with all of this. It's not capital. I'm an anti-capitalist. It's not capitalism. I'm not an anti-capitalist because we don't have capitalism. We have corporate welfare. We have social capital, socialism / capitalism, some beast hybrid devastating all of the planet. It's not capitalism. This whole false dichotomy, capitalism versus socialism, left versus right. What about what's down the center? What about the neutral? Have you heard Joseph Campbell's Bill Moyers segment on the Grail, the Holy Grail? It came from the neutral angels. Came down the center, not from the angels on the left or the right, but the neutral, natural angels, neuter, neither. That's the Grail. And the Grail is the symbol of the one, what comes to the one who lives his or her own life for his or her, in his or herself, in the center, the center, balanced, harmonized, integrated, and does not get sucked into the mainstream nonsense. The one who takes the road less traveled, which makes all the difference, as in the Robert Frost poem, that's the one who gets the Grail King, the G-Rail, Ra-El, King Arthur. Cognitive dissonance, you know, that's the state when you hear the truth, right? But, oh, It's threatening my precious worldview. The precious. Remember the precious in the Lord of the Rings? Yeah, the ring of power. Saturn's rings. Time is money. Is Saturn, is Satan, Kronos, chronology, that which eats its, Ouroboros, that which just eats its own tail and keeps going round and round, never getting anywhere. Remember that, the precious, that's what, how people are about their worldview, their paradigm. It's their precious, and they don't want it shaken. I'm free. I'm in the free, the land of the free, the home of the brave, and I have a government that cares about me. And they're looking after me. Sometimes there's bad government people like Donald Trump. Oh, he's so terrible. He's such a sexist, misogynist, racist pig. But Obama, oh, he was such a nice man. Obama was the fucking drone king. Wake up. Your worldview is not precious, not sacred, or what you regard as precious. It's disgusting. It's part of the problem with what's why we're going extinct as we speak. Because people can't look in the mirror and be honest. The mass majority of people are never honest. They think they're free. They're enslaved by money. You are a slave, Neo. They don't. The last thing these people ever want to have to experience is what Neo experiences in the Matrix. What I experienced, and I continue experiencing, you know, when you come out of your pod, out of your precious little worldview, you take out that tube and you get out of that pod and you look around and you see that you're surrounded by people, by your fellow human beings, which you were just now as being used as a battery, harvested for your energy. That's what a worker is. It's one who's being harvested, a human resource. These people, they never want to see that. They want to stay in their pods. As Morpheus tells Neo, these people aren't ready to be unplugged. And they could be an agent at any moment. The agent could come in and take them, and they will defend their worldview. They will defend the system that's enslaving them to the end, to the bitter end. It's fucked. We're in a fucked up situation. A people farm. Earth's being strip mined systematically. Oh, looks like I'm gonna have to do another video. Foreseen Beyond Time will be the next one, because I'm out of time. Namaste, hallelujah, Hare Krishna, aloha. God bless you, may the force be with you.